Hello, my friends. Thank you for coming. Before we going to talk about the hydraulic system of the Boeing 747, I want to show you a short video of an accident of Japan Airlines flight 123, Boeing 747 crashing and killing 520 people. Let's watch the video. I'm going to show it to you on the iPad and not directly on the screen because of copyright issues. Please watch.
The pilots fight to control the aircraft, unaware that their basic flight controls are permanently disabled. The plane climbs and dips. The pilots struggle to maneuver with engine thrust alone.
The video that you just saw was the worst ever single aircraft accident with 520 people died. In Tenerife disaster, more people died, but this was involving two aircraft colliding one each other, and this is a single one. Anyway, the route for this accident, this Japan Airlines 123 accident, started 7 years before the accident when this aircraft suffered from a tail strike. A tail strike is a situation when the tail of the aircraft touch the ground on takeoff, and it can cause, due to a low rotation speed or too high rotation rate done by the pilot. In any situation, the angle of attack is too high on takeoff before the plane leaves the ground and the tail touch the runway. In this situation, most of the time, the pilot will continue the takeoff and just go back for landing, and this plane will have to go for a serious heavy maintenance. That was the situation in this Boeing 747. Unfortunately, the repair that has been done by the manufacturer wasn't done right, and there was mistakes while they were fixing this plane. And 7 years after, the rear bulkhead of this plane just explode and causing a serious damage to the tail section of the plane, and moreover causing the rupture of the four hydraulic system of this Boeing 747. All the flight controls of the Boeing 747, it moves by hydraulic pressure go from these four systems. Without hydraulic pressure, the flight controls cannot move. There is no manual reversion in Boeing 747, which means you have to have hydraulic pressure to move the flight controls. Let's talk a little bit about the hydraulic system of the Boeing 747. As I say, it has four hydraulic systems, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Each hydraulic system receiving pressure in the air from two hydraulic pumps. One is called the EDP, it's the engine driving pump, and the second one called the demand pump. The EDP, the engine driving pump, it's rotated by the engine gearbox, and as long as the engine is running and there is hydraulic fluid in the system, there is a hydraulic pressure for this system. This system, of course, has one switch, one button, which on or off, and it's most of the time just stays in on. And whenever the engine is starting, we're getting the hydraulic pressure to the system. The second one called the demand pump. And this one is kind of a pump that stays on standby. It has a three switch position, off, auto, and on. Of course, in off, the pump is off. In auto, the pump will start pumping the hydraulic pressure into the system on a system logic requirements, which means if there is a high demand for the hydraulic pressure in the system, or for instance, if the EDP, the engine driving pump, will fail, the demand pump will jump into the system and supplying the required hydraulic pressure. I say in brackets that the fourth system has three hydraulic system or hydraulic pumps, when the third one is an electrical hydraulic pump that works only on the ground for startup for pressurize the system for brakes and gears. So, but this is out of the game on the air, so I put it aside. So each consumer get his hydraulic pressure from its own system, and there is no connection between the system. So of course you will ask me, okay, so what about the backup between the in the system, in the backup for the consumers? So the hydraulic system arranged in a very special and a beautiful way, which there is some consumer that getting hydraulic pressure from only one system, for instance the autopilot, and that's why you have three autopilots, and each autopilot get the hydraulic pressure from its own system. So even if we have two system fail, we still have autopilot. About the flight controls that works on hydraulic only without manual reversion, as I said, most of the flight controls getting hydraulic pressure from two system in a combination, that in any situation, as long as we have two hydraulic system available, we still can fly the plane safely. As a pilot, we do know what to do when we have one single hydraulic system fail. Yes, we know what to do with two hydraulic system fail. We do not have procedures and reference for what to do with three hydraulic system fails. And as I said before, and as we can see in the accident, the plane cannot fly with four hydraulic system fail. The only time that there's a four hydraulic system fail was in this very unfortunate accident, but there was some mistake in the system that was been fixed, and now this thing never happened again. Me personally, as a captain, when I was flying at the 747-200, I had a system 4 fail. We had a leak on the system, and we have to go back for landing. We landed safely with the correct procedures, so it's not an issue. So now that you understand generally how the hydraulic system in the Boeing 747 works, you can understand better the reason, part of the reason for this very unfortunate accident, and to know that what was wrong there was fixed, and since there, Boeing 747 flying millions of flight, and thank God, as far as I know, never have a situation that more than two hydraulic system fail. So thank you for watching. Hope you like it, and have a lovely day, evening, and if you're flying, always fly safe. Me personally, always I rather be flying. Have a great day.